Hello, welcome to the Bronze Works. My name is Sean Monahan, and I'm going to be pouring a hydrocal plaster of this sculpture. It was done by Joy Ma, Jody Croce's mother, many years ago, and probably in the 60s, I think.
68.
68-ish, that's right. And this is her daughter, Zoe.
Hi.
Ted's the cameraman, by the way.
Hi.
Anyway, we're going to be mixing a hydrocal plaster. It's a very hard form of plaster of Paris, essentially, with water. And I'm going to be pouring it into the mold. I'm going to mix it with an electric mixer for a few minutes, and then we'll just brush it in and let it set. You know what I want to do, actually? I want to double check that it's level. Because I moved it since I last checked it. And that looks good enough.
Yes, it's quite important.
Because the gravity is going to dictate, you know, the back side. So yeah, looks good. Looks good. Great. All right. So now I just have to refer to my recipe. I've got 13.4 pounds of water, and I need to do 30 pounds of hydrocal to match that. So. Turn on my scale and get it zeroed out, and then I can just measure out 30 pounds.
I see why it's so dusty in here.
Yeah, right? We don't do this kind of work much, but there's lots of dust. Yeah, it doesn't help that there's a gravel tower across the street.
Oh.
On granite rock. All right, there's 4.5 pounds. We've got a long way to go. Oops, easy, because we're going to go for about 30 here. You want to kind of sprinkle it in gradually. Let the water kind of absorb slowly. All right, there's almost half of our plaster. Warm day today, I'll probably mix it a little less long. Not quite as long a time as I did last time. Alright, with the 22 pounds. Starting to form a little island in the bottom there. You can see it start to form a little, little island.
Very active. It's
shaking. Yeah, there's a little slaking. Yep, sleeping. The air bubbles are kind of soaking in. So let's see. We still got about 27 pounds. Two more to go here. Call that good. So now we want to let this soak for just a couple of minutes. So I will turn on my timer.
Soak before you stir?
Yeah. So that's called slaking, and you get a more even distribution of the water.
It does kind of smell bad.
There's a little bit of a
weird smell.
Kind of a weird smell, I suppose.
It's very strange.
It is a
consistency.
Weird material. Yeah, it's kind of a yogurty, milky kind of a thing.
This looks thinner than the first one.
We stirred it a lot longer, the last one.
Oh, that's what thickened
it
up.
And I didn't like how thick that got, how quickly that got thick on us.
I see.
That's why I only mix this about 3 or 4 minutes instead of like 6 or 7 minutes. But it will indeed.
It'll thicken.
It will indeed go rock-like on us. Yeah, you that figure that you had was probably some version of this, probably a hydrocal or something. That one that broke in the parking lot?
Yeah.
The market?
She's still laying over on my desk over there.
Is she?
All taped and glued back together.
Well, one of these days.
One of these days.
One of these days. Tools here just for a second. Before they get too hard.
Make sure you work fast.
And let's see here.
This was your pattern for your wax?
Yeah. So I made that.
You have to do this to keep the antenna and everything all.
Yeah, what I did is I built the sprues into the mold. Because I. I made that one in wax.
It's like you could double as a dentist.
I know. I got lots of dental tools over there. Lots of.
Is this actually? No.
Some of those are.
Are actually dental tools?
Yeah, I've got lots of little things that go.
Oh yeah.
These great retail tools for that.
Is that a swimmer from Peter Weston's?
Actually, that's a piece that James here bought from Maynard Manson. I have a Manson family. Manson family.
It went through my fire. I had a fire at my house. And she was up on the second floor. She was sitting on a big piece of granite. And she fell through the floor and the granite cracked. But the girl still survived. So.
Is that why she's all like, I don't know what?
The patina is all from the fire.
Yeah, I mean, it's cool. It looks really good.
Sean thinks I ought to leave it alone. I wanted him to refinish it, but
he's dragging his feet. I like it.
He's dragging his feet and hasn't ever done it. So.
I think it looks good.
Well,
it's special. You can't recreate that. It's a house fire patina.
That's right.
One of a kind.
There's no other foundry in that. There's no other like commercial foundry.
Right.
It does work for other people. We said circa 68.
And then what you wrote, Plaster, Sean Monahan.
That's right.
She stands on her own, stands.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy that he said that was the only thing left in his house.
Was it
bronze? Or is this something? Yeah, it is bronze, yeah. And it was in a house fire, and it fell from the second floor to the first floor and
broke some granite.
It had a double granite base, two discs, with a little Lazy Susan in between them, so it could turn.
Oh, that's what she was standing on?
Yeah.
Oh, and that broke.
She was bolted to it. It was quite big, because her hair, it was very big and heavy. This would be, I guess I could say
October 2017.
Say something like that, I think.
I think just 2017, but
okay,
October if you want.
Yeah, it works.
They don't have to match.
Yeah. 2017, that's close enough. All right.
That's
good.
Nice.
Excellent.
I'll dust that off. Time comes.
Looks good. Very cool.
Yeah, so how long do you think you'll be gone this time, Zoe?
coming back in.